We know from our studies of Antarctica's past that when greenhouse gas levels are high, temperatures are high, and the ice sheet melts, sea level goes up. We know that a warming of 2 degrees can cause the ice sheet to melt such that sea level goes up by 20 metres. This amount of sea level rise in our future would be devastating for our coastal communities. We have to avoid it. COP26, to me, it offers a real opportunity for us all. It's hope. My kids were lamenting the fact that the climate system's going to change and it's going to be not a very bright future for them. And that's horrible, right? And it's a massive burden to bear. And so I've realised that we need to promote this sense of hope and the fact that we can make a difference. And COP26 is one of those key make a difference moments for humanity. Here we have the international powers coming together to make what is arguably one of the most important decisions in all of human history. What will our future be? Will it be one that is warm to the point that the ice sheets melt, sea level goes up by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 meters, and our coastal communities have to adapt to a large amount of change that will be disruptive and disastrous? Or do our leaders say, right, we'll get these emissions under control and keep warming to a minimum such that Antarctica doesn't melt as much and the effect of that change in Antarctica is much smaller and manageable? So what we've learned from our studies in Antarctica is that there is room to move. We've still got time. We haven't quite crossed the threshold where Antarctic ice sheet melt becomes unstoppable. The window is small. We don't have a lot of time. We've got to act now, but we do have the chance to avoid that large, damaging, and catastrophic change in Antarctica that will affect the world.